See, boom, boom. Okay. So, well, how many? Da-da-da. Two people. Hello. How's it going? So today, instead of like having an episode of the usual Discord programming, we're gonna have like special edition. Basically, like just something came up, so now I have to switch. But yeah, no problem. So today, as the title says, I'm gonna work. I mean, I had little idea. So there is like at least what is it? Subreddit. So Reddit data is beautiful. I think that's what it is. So I thought like I might do something cool for that. But first I need to search if it was already done. So graphical names. So the idea would be to get all the names, all the names of like locations, say, use graphical, maybe, okay, so getting all the names of like locations, like, but not like just countries, but like, things like provinces and states and like small maybe cities and things like that to see like if there's a pattern maybe between like a country or worldwide, like maybe has some sort of like prefix and like postfix, I guess. Just for fun. And so I thought I'm gonna do that. So nothing special, so like we're just gonna parse, try to get like some sort of intuition in maybe like we can split them by region, we can split them by country, and so on. And then try to draw them to like some sort of plot and show like statistics and stuff. So, first of all, let's cut some music. So, go out. And put some music. This is random. Is it okay? How's the sound there? Sounds good. If you guys don't hear me or if there's any problem, just ping me. Let me know. Okay. So let's go. So first of all, as usual, we'll do some sort of like repository. Geographical names visualize. Maybe. Something like that. Maybe an L in there. And just maybe we need to have a red name. Okay, too high. This is like V plus. I heard like somebody suggested to me, and I'm just gonna listen to some random stuff. So now we have it here. I'm just gonna like clone it. So just simply and I haven't thought of just anything like of the language of any of just I want to see what kind of like data sets I find, and I'm gonna find what kind of like things are like graph applications that are easy to use. Okay, so well, we'll start with that. Oh, we got it. So something like that. Maybe data set countries and cities of country. Regions will be more vague as well. And I'll put like that one is on GitHub because maybe it's already ready for us. Awesome world. Countries. Oh, maybe. Yeah, I would expect something like that. Like it's sort of a crazy list. So this one goes already into a SQL. which is okay, that's so is ID, name and code, country. So there are cities, regions, provinces and states. So ID, name, code and the country ID, I guess. So the one it relates to. So I guess the country ID can be connected on, so code, so we need to get, for the countries you get a code, for the, then for the region you get the same code, for the cities you need to go through the foreign key to countries table. Okay, so country ID is ID and, I was blind. So they have all country ID and they all refer to it there. Perfect. Can we see? Can we see something? So this is good, but there are cities, regions. There are a lot of cities. So I guess it could be nice. This is a little bit complicated for nothing. Ready for maybe already implemented. So we got football, world, awesome world. So country city codes. Then there is country cities, geo names, geo tree. I guess they're just like the natural earth, like it seems they give you like layers like this. But here was like slash export. No, just generation. So no, the names export. You find, okay, downloads. It's divided per one per country. There was something like, what is the, like all countries, all cities, all countries. 300 and. You can try with one and see what it contains, I guess. A small one, this one, XK. Okay. Let's try to see this one. So, SK. Okay, so this one is like, we can't see really. Let me check. Maybe you can show. Bit of a mess. Some mess. Visualize this mess, but so they go in ID, they got the like tab separated apparently. So if you go like this, this is separated away, So they don't give you this kind of information. Not sure. Let's keep on looking. Let's switch this on. So 330 megabytes. This was only cities though, so we don't like particular. That's same. And This how much is big? How big is it? 30 megabytes. So geographical database cover all country connect over 80 place names. You can browse and see. Mother Root 2, cha-cha. So let's say this one for Europe, let's say Europe. Belarus. Oh no. So just like two cities. Belarus is not. So the cities. Yeah, I don't like this one. Pain in the ass to parse. So this one. So there are 3,808 regions. Could be okay. But I'm curious. So let's go to Europe. This one was not too bad. So this one. Let's see. So let's go to here. Let's go to Italy. Oh, this is Zagreb, Rome. This go by okay. It goes by capital. Like I'm just curious. Like if it's only cities, then I'm just gonna use the other one because it's the same. But if he goes for like even like known, so this like let's see, I'll go up here. And they also give you things like just common names. That would be cool. So this is also for like mountains. It's a mountain. That's not bad. There's a lot of stuff. Ah, this is cool, man. I guess that's why it's like 330 stuff. So how would we import all this? So seeing what we are given an ID, the location and everything, coordinates, the code for the country, some other stuff. So country info, feature code, read me. So all country, alternate names, so this is like everything. So the main generating table is so the ID, the name, the ASCII name, alternate, latitude, longitude, feature class. It's okay. So I guess we can parse. So feature class. So you got T here. I'm saying kind of like I'm comparing what we just saw. So country code, XK, feature code, country code, then alternate country code, admin code, pips code, media population. I guess we just want names really, and then the country, like I guess this will be okay. It's gonna be fine. So, meantime, I download everything. Generals all countries. Boom, 336 megabytes. Yeah, we'll download this. So that will work for all, and Castle in the Sky theme, not bad. So in the meantime that I'm downloading, you can look into some sort of like visualization graphs and stuff. So there was some cool stuff to try. Data visualization or statistics. So let's see. If he has some images, can we pick some language? So there's Python first, other than me. Web apps, well, what? No, maybe it's not really. So SJ plot. SJ statistic R. Or something like beautiful. Beautiful chart for data. Big data, we don't need, just beautiful chart. Okay. That seems to be online. So, first UI, blah blah boom. So, let's see. Yeah, HTML, blah blah blah. And you get charts like that. And let's put Python maybe. Not really. It doesn't really matter, does it? But if I found some sort of cool, so let's see, volume, Python data, documentation, gallery. So, maybe this one. I don't know. Oh, not bad. So this one shows you nicely. This one like a PNG maybe. program. Yeah, let's see. Let's start again. Pretty fast. Where is the computer getting solved? My laptop is getting quite hot. You know, it's warm here, but let me check. Yeah, I don't want to do that. So I guess I have to pick between hot laptop, noise. To bear with me with it, guys. So anyway, I am at 50% download. So graphics. There's no kind of. What type of graphs I'm looking for? Making charts and stuff. Yeah, okay, great. I'm gonna do this one. We're going for this. Boom, X chart. We can plot data. We can export. Beautiful. Okay, easy. I don't see why we have to like fight and suffer. So, do I have Eclipse? Yes. So, I'm gonna go for you. Yeah. Future ball. So the data set looks like this. So it's gonna be easy because we rely by line, and then we split. We just get the first, and then we might get the country. Well, we get a country code. We get a country, and like we can put them inside some sort of structure where. There's an ID. Somebody making a mess. Hello. So this would be one key. It's like nested. Okay. Which maybe we don't even care, to be honest. Because we have to like handle them as. Oh, you can make a bunch of like this. Make a bunch of all this stuff. So now let's in here maybe. Okay. Good. Okay. So let's switch. So we can get just. Get started. So new. So I make a new Java project. We make it geographical. No. So geographical names visualized. We're going 1.8 and okay. It's a nice create is creating stuff. So for the moment we use the small file and then the one make the big one. That way we're not gonna go crazy if we go through the big one. So now geographical name source look again. So data my data and now it's gonna be just there and we'll call it test. Are you still there? Okay. So, as well, this is a building project. I'll also close this. So now let's data there and great. So make a new one and phone new package and we call it com products. To visualization. Your name is visualization. And boom. Now we got a package here and we're gonna have a class. Class is just remain this is where we have the we have this program. Then we'll have a class, so an object which is a continent, Europe, so a continent. Then we need a country, and then we need a just place. So the continent will have a public or private. Public string name and public like an array of countries and that's it. A country will be very similar. List of places and places, and the place just has a name as home. So here on public continent we'll get a string name and the countries. Can I generate this? Sometimes you can generate. So maybe edit. I like to try to learn if there's some like work completion prefix contest assets. Source generate it and setter using fields. Beautiful. Yeah, beautiful. Boom. Moving on with the suppressor. Do the same here. Shortcut is not shortcut. Emit and boom. Clean up a bit. Same for this one. Okay. Great. So now it's really easy. Here we have the generator also generate. Maybe when I want to try. Public static string box. That's okay. And we do a system of why you're not good at this? Why are you on making art? Oh, Pentelem. Oh, mishmash of languages. So we'll run. Okay. Make a new Java application, and the main class is with the main. Did I make a message on them? Yeah, that's why you always try to run and see if you messed up. Boom. So now we got to read things out. So let me go back here and we'll just look it up. Java parse text file. It's quite easy. So we got a path there and we go through. So for each stuff that we parse, we just want to make we have a list we need. So this is going to just run the application. So we need another one. I'm going to make it here. And this is like file parser. This one should return a list of continents, maybe. So this only parses. And so then we have public file parser string file path and then a private string fp or file path as well. File path equals file path, and this way we can have a nice little worker and we get file parser fp equals new file parser, and then we have a data test.txt and that's it. And then we have a public void file parser parser. This will return a continent. Basics and returns then. And here we do continents. This way, when you have this one, then we can start like we can just do some logic and it's already built in, and we can do everything we need. So continents equals fp dot parse. That's it. And now for now what we do is that in continent we can do a so need overload constructor delegate string. Ta-da-da, generate skip new value. I think it's fine. So it becomes name. Oh. Maybe fine. We can do this. And we can try to see how this works. And then it's not good. Generate to string. Then we can go through all those and just like do whatever we want to test. We can test. And then what we do is like for each, or no, not for each, for continent C, continents, we do C dot. System out println c dot string, and then we just see what we got. here it should always be the string, we should just get just all the, like, I mean, just one country. Depends on how we parse it though. So now we're parsing, and we have to go back to example here. So yeah, I guess this one's fine. So no inputs kind of file, next token, next. Ah, you can affect form. This one is Kikujiro no Natsu. Oh, it isn't. So this one is file path. Yes, we can. Do try catch maybe? Throw. Throw. Okay. So we'll have next line. So we go four line. So current line. In the curl line, we just print them out. And we'll just print out all the lines to see that we're getting something. And then we'll return out. Or, oh no, return like this. Otherwise it breaks, I guess. Turn new component. Array here, yeah, okay. And here we'll probably need to package. Or yeah, I don't know. Beautiful, very easy. Now we have to split by the tab. Split by tab, we get the first. Does it mean the first one? Let's check. Oops. I never remember that. So, that is the ASCII name. ASCII name is better because then we can compare things similarly instead of like just going, maybe there's accents and something like that, but that might, maybe we should save both, to be honest. So in, I guess in places there should be ASCII name and local name maybe. So and there we do. Why that too? Is it for me? Boom. Yep. So for each line, instead of now, of course, we can print them out. So we need a list or array list of continents. Continent. We call it continents. New array list of continent. Boom. This way we don't have to worry too much about like how many there are, although we know how many there are, but two array should be enough. Type of continent. Ah, different. I remember this little like casting to do always and always mean because create array from unknown. Make a list array. That's bad. Maybe this one. Not pretty standardized for Java. Tomorrow, hello. But it's continent. Okay, so now we are here and we are parsing. So now we have to parse some stuff. First, we need first of all, we build a place. So first, we get ASCII name equals current line. I'm gonna split it because it's actually gonna be easy. Split by tab. In this way, we're splitting by tab, which is great. And now we go for our current line, and we know that the first or second one is the ASCII name. Then we have local name. So actually what we do is that we do place b equals new place, and we got the local name so we made a new place. Now we need to make a new country, which we might not have to do as a problem. So for the country, for the place is definitely unique. For the countries, it is that is an interesting one, because I think maybe we might not need that. Actually, we might need to have. So definitely all the places. So now we build in all the places. What if everything is a place? Has a country? But then I can just go through once. And then if I need to like do something with it, I find I can just go through. But then but the later no, it doesn't matter. Be in different order. So a little tricky. Wait, is there a better theme? Oh, thank you. What? Oh, okay. Now we're talking. Just thought about it. Because if I go through each of them and then I see play and like the country and like Europe / back, right? Then we don't have even have the country. Let's have the city there. Country will be the code. The problem is that we're gonna be duplicating lots of data if we just store everything millions of times. It will be the same as this one, which makes no sense. We'll have to do a little content. So hash code constructor delegate contains so I need to look up part of it. So, things to custom class. Or at least custom contains method. Need to override these two equals and hash code. Okay. Very straightforward. So if this is the same object, hash code will occur. Yeah, same, it's just strings really. I mean, country doesn't really need to check about places. If there's the word places, then okay. That's it. We only want it to be about the places. Yeah, only one about the name. So if different name, different places. So. And for the place, we is not gonna happen. And for it could happen if it's exactly the same. So let's do a compare for everything. Do lists and generate. Same idea basically. And here we care that it's the same. We only just gonna check. We're just gonna pick one. We're gonna pick the ASCII name as unique. In this way, yeah, we don't know. And just ASCII name. Boom, boom. So we got name and countries. Countries we don't care. Countries we don't care either. Boom. Done. So what we can do here now is having a list of everything. So a list of continent. Then we Accounting has worked hours before that. And yes. So, my list of countries. This way, whenever we find a country, we can say add one. You need to find country. So we make a list. Because if we turn this one to more release, we just need to create that one, and every time we find a continent, instead if it's like, yeah, like, it's not great, I guess. Now we factor, I change type, use super type, extract, move. Should have thought earlier about this one. Luckily we're not using that one there. So boom. Let's do it automatically. So what constructor using fields. Boom. So it's just string. Boom. No border. Yeah, this is way easier. Same for this. So constructor tomb and a border. Okay, and place the same. All right, so now we just need to make a continent. So in the continent we can have that we provide that one, but we can also that we can just provide an empty this one, and it's going to be continent name and a new save. This way we just reuse, and so country does the same. This way it's just a bit easier to get started. And we reuse the foot. So as we are doing new release of continent, continents, and we've got our list of continents. As we're looking for new one, we add, great. Yeah, so now we're gonna place, we made a place. Now, continent, make new continent, and we make, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So continent becomes current line 12, I guess, dot split by, because there's a double there, and then we get the one before. What is this? Oh yeah, continent, you can see. So this is a temporary continent, because if continents dot contains, see, then we don't do it. So if it doesn't contain C, then continents add C. Then we do it. So now I wonder if like is added by reference. I don't think so. So now we added it. Yeah. Actually, so contains. Okay. Then what we do continents index of C dot net. Probably there's a smarter way, but I just want to do it quickly. And we do countries dot add uppercase. Now we have a country, which we don't find out yet. So we do country. Country is made by the same as that one, but instead of being a 0 is the 1, so we can change the order. Place country continent on C. Okay. So countries. So, countries, so if countries.contains country, so if it doesn't contain country, this one but add country. And then this one, but add, wait, dot index of country dot. So now I have a country. Oh, countries dot get. Crazy. I think I should just get the index, save the index. Using too many times. So yeah, so if it was added, it's the last one. Index of continent. Now we're doing index of continent. Then we do the same for right. We got countries. So now we have it, and we do index of. Country. So now we know the index of the country. Let's make that. So maybe temporary. So with index of country, I do. So continents dot get index of continent dot countries dot get index of country dot. Now we can do places dot add, and definitely has never been added place, or maybe we can check. So if home is dot contains B. If it doesn't contain it, then we'll add it. We're back. Oof, crazy. And then that's it. So we try and break it. Bound exception 1. Why? 26. Yeah, so probably this line is incorrect. Okay. It's around there, so I know. Okay. Now we'll check. Because there's explanation here, so let's see. Where are your explanation? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Ooh, I was off. 16. Let's try. 16, so. 16 there. So can we maybe still print the stuff out, and then we'll see when we get there. So front line 15. See what we get. Number. Not a number. Ooh, 17, that was the right number. How comes? Alright. Yeah, maybe that's... Are you kidding me? Maybe it's just one. You are kidding me, mate. Sometimes it's empty. That worked. So I guess we'll have to. string, let's say call it region split, if region dot linked different than true, we don't do it, actually equals true, then we can do it. Then we can basically little check. I thought that, like, we could trust the data like that, but apparently never trust the data. Okay, let's do some formatting here. Ctrl Shift F. Boom. And else system.out.println non-conform I found. Then we do the input dot before the whole line, I guess. So we can print it out. We find something. We found something, but okay, because we're printing the line. So this is like da-da-da. Okay. That should be fine. Found some no conform line, but you can show it. And now, so yeah, so basically now we have program C to string, and we are going through the continents, and we are printing out all the countries. How about C dot name? And then we'll go through like. Just Europe. So I found three lines which were not conform. Why? Oh, what did they have? They did not have a region. Which shouldn't be like that, shouldn't it? Although they are. I think we should just. But then we don't know where to put them, right? Yeah, we'll skip them now. Okay. So now we're going through. So we do a for country. Dot countries. Then we do system dot out dot println cc dot. See what countries we are getting. Oh yeah, no country really. Because the country is no country. Damn. These are the cities. Country is the other one. City. To refactor everything first, and it's like a city. Then we don't care about it. No, no, it's fine. It's a city. Okay. We keep it as a country, and then we drop the city. We pick someone else. So the factor. Why can't I refactor? Okay. So it's fine, and the only difference is that of when we're parsing it, instead of taking the one for the country, we have to take number 0, okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We'll have to take 7. Yes. Okay. 7 and 8. Always counting. Yeah. Because it's only one country. XK. Like Albania. That is good. And then we can do the same for the places here. We have a bunch of names now, like all the names are going to be here, and it's like there's hotels and things like that. So some duplicates. Good. So I guess today, we're gonna just like do the part one loading. And then we're running on the big one. Instead, we'll revert here. Of course, places might be too many. Then we can do for countries. And we run for all countries. Because now it's been downloaded. And then we create the night and go to sleep. So this one is 300 megabytes compressed. So it's a bit of a beast. This is all countries in the world. Oh, 1 gigabyte, and can't push this stuff. So all countries that they see. That's it. Will it work? So now I copy it. And ready to go. Oh, I'm gonna find so many now. Now I'm gonna sit back and chill out. Because it's not gonna take me a little time. So how's the we don't even know how many already been processed. In the meantime, we do all the new stuff. 5 minutes. 5 minutes, okay? Okay. Thank you. Where? File parser 42. Oh, what happened? Java index array out of bound exception. Now I can fix it last time. But basically, maybe this one is different then. So basically, if not found, I guess. I'm not checking if not found. Or doesn't contain. If he doesn't find one, fine. Why does it exist? I'm gonna have to log now, and it will go, otherwise that's gonna kill me. So I shall push everything to the new geography. Just add source. Okay, so this became a two-part, since essentially like a lot of data, and but like think about it. So good. So now it's been pushed, and let's double check that. And just rapidly, boom. So if anybody wants to work on it, it's there. And yeah, good. So that's all for tonight. Tonight, I have to like be abrupt because it's quite late and I'm in my place, and so people want to go to sleep. So good night and bye bye.